let's talk communication. Communication is super important. And so one of the main way that communication happens at GCC is through your GCC email account. And so this is the part of the presentation where I really stress the importance of checking that account and checking it every day. Your GCC email is how the college officially communicates with you. So you may, during the summer, have gotten stuff sent to your personal email. I know that for orientation, I want to make sure you get the info. So I have been using your GCC email and your personal email to reach out to you. But once the semester starts, it's going to be all GCC email all the time, no other email. This is how the college communicates with you. It's how we know you are who you say you are, that we're communicating with the person we're supposed to be. Anything the college wants you to know, it's going to that email account. It's how your instructors are going to communicate with you, how your advisors are going to communicate with you. And the reason why you want to check it on a daily basis is, honestly, you're going to get a decent amount of email. And if you put it off, you're going to open it at the end of the week, and you're going to agree it's going to be, whoa, all this email. And you're going to be like, I feel overwhelmed. So we don't want you to feel overwhelmed, but we do want you to have the information you need. And if you're checking it on a daily basis, you can like weed through like, yep, this applies to me. I need to do something about this. This doesn't apply to me. I don't need to worry about it. So yes, email, GCC account, check it every day. If you haven't already figured this out, and the way you get to your email, the same way you got to Moodle today and the same way you get to my GCC is through this blue login button on the main page. While we're here at the login button, I just want to point out that the search bar is very handy for looking up all kinds of things GCC. I use it regularly. I know other staff and faculty and students use it regularly. So don't be afraid of the search bar if you are trying to find something at GCC. When you click on that login button, this drop-down menu comes up. So you can get to my GCC, you can get the Moodle, and you can get to your student email there. You can also get to the student help desk, which is where you can go if you're having, you know, some tech problems, especially if it's account related. Just a reminder, don't share your GCC login credentials with anyone. We're going to talk a little bit about FERPA later, but we need to make sure that when we are communicating with a student, we are communicating with that student and not with someone who is not that student or might be pretending to be that student. So keep your login information to yourself. Don't share it with others. That's usually a good life principle. When you click on that email link, it brings you to this Gmail sign-in. Make sure you are signed out of any other personal Gmail accounts you might have, or things will go a little wonky. What's nice about that link is it fills in this @stuemail.gcc.mass.edu, so you don't have to type that all in. If you do have other Gmail accounts, obviously you know you can just add the GCC one to the list of accounts that you have. Speaking about emails and the importance of checking it, on Monday mornings, you will get a weekly email that's titled News and Updates for Students. Please make sure you read this email. It'll have information about upcoming events, but also have information about deadlines and due dates and that sort of thing. One of my colleagues years ago said, a lot of disappointment comes from students not checking their GCC email because students, you know, missed out on a deadline to apply for a scholarship, or they missed out on an event that they actually really wanted to go to. And so I don't want you to have that level of disappointment. I want you to be happy and fulfilled. So please make sure you check your email. Definitely read this specific email just so you get a sense of like what's going on and what you might want to do. All right. We are on the social media. You can find us on Facebook. You can find us on Twitter, and you can find us on Instagram. So please find those Facebook pages and like them. Please follow us on Twitter and Instagram. That's another way to find out about things that are going on campus and related to GCC in general. All right, technology, it's our friend. We're gonna talk about it. First, we're gonna talk about my GCC. Ooh, it's always fascinating when you're doing a presentation and you've done it like 10 times and just this time, notice that there is a typo on it. My GCC is all one word. Distracted by errors. So my GCC is the Student Information Management System. It's where you can access your schedule, find out who your advisor is, pay your bill, find out financial aid information. There's all kinds of stuff hanging out in my GCC. When you log in, it should look pretty much like this. Over here on the left-hand side, you have a menu with things like, as I mentioned, schedule, advisor, paying your bill. This submit a form button has a lot of forms hiding under it, and we're going to look at that in a second. Some other things I want to point out about my GCC over here on the left-hand side are announcements. It's how you got here to register for orientation. You'll notice this alert GCC update reminder. We're going to talk about that at the end of the presentation, and other announcements will show up here as well. Then you can also find some event information here. And then over here on the right-hand side are the dates that are coming up soonest in the academic calendar. So that's also important to pay attention to. Up here at the top, you'll see a tab that says My Account. That's where you can update your personal information. So if you haven't double-checked that, I really encourage that you do so. Make sure your cell phone number is correct. Make sure your address is correct. One of the things that I find fascinating is when a student's cell phone number is not their own cell phone number, but their parent's cell phone number, and it should be yours, so make sure it is. The other thing that you can change in your personal information is if you have a preferred name that isn't your legal name and the name that you want people to use. You can change it here. It'll show up on class rosters and that sort of thing. And people, you know, those of us who have access to like searching will be able to search for you by that preferred name. You'll notice in the lower right-hand corner, there it was either a picture of you if you have a student ID or it says no photo. That's a button. And if you click on that button, it will bring you to your dashboard. But before we go to your dashboard, I want to talk about not that. I want to talk about the submit a form button. So I mentioned there's a bunch of forms hanging out under this button. And as you can see, there are a ton of things. You can change your major, you can change your advisor, you can find out the process to request an official transcript, you can drop a class, you can withdraw from all of your classes. If you need to verify that you are a, don't mind me, I'm just making notes to myself, sorry. If you need to verify that you're a student at GCC for any reason, for your job, for a program that you're part of, anything like for some sort of benefit, you can request a verification request through this button. And there's other things there as well. So a whole bunch of stuff that you can do really easily straight from my GCC. I don't know why it keeps being so cranky, but eventually we're gonna get where we're gonna go. So I hope I didn't make you too dizzy. All right, so when you click on that button, it's either a photo of you or says no photo, it brings you to your dashboard. Your dashboard has a bunch of stuff on it. First, if you ever forget your student ID number, it's hiding here under this button. You can just click it and it will show you what your ID number is. This gives you a kind of top level schedule information. You know, the course, the dates it runs, when it needs, if it has a specific meeting time. If it does have specific meeting times, it'll tell you the days. This is where I want to point out to you that GCC uses single letter abbreviations for days of the week. So that means Tuesdays are T and Thursdays are R. So this is not a class that only meets on Thursdays. This is a class that meets Tuesdays and Thursdays. But if you want a more detailed version of your schedule, you can find that here. We're going to talk about that in a second too. If you need an unofficial copy of your transcript, you have access to it right here in my GCC. You can just print it off. Trying to think, is there anything else? I feel like there's something else I wanted to point out to you all, but darn if I can remember what it is. Also, see, I know this person completed orientation and means they did their survey. If this person had class, if if this person had classes on campus, the room number would be here. Something that's really important to know about room numbers is that they start with a letter. So if it says N, it means your class is in the north wing. If it starts with S, your class is in the south wing. If it says E, your class is in the other building, the east building. And then now I'm going to show you what it looks like when you click on the view schedule button. There's a couple things I want to point out to you there. It's going to do the same. I don't know why it's being so cranky, y'all. I'm not loving it. All right, there we go. That'll make it better. Okay, so this gives you more detailed information. One of the things I want to draw your attention to is this is a class that meets on campus. See what I meant about starting with the letter? So this class meets in the south wing in room 338. Now, you might be wondering, hey, how do I get the books for my class? Here is the answer to your question. If you click on that view schedule link, you can get to this. You'll get your schedule, and then there's purchase books at the bookstore button right here, and that will bring you to the bookstore, and it will list all of your classes and the books associated with that class. The other thing that your detailed schedule will have are notes about the class. So Social 106 is a class that has no required meeting times. This course is a hybrid course that meets one day a week on campus, and the rest of it's online. So those are the other things you can find in that detailed version. I do want to pause right here, and you might be thinking, all right, I have classes on campus. How the heck am I going to find them? Well, I have a little bit of information for you about that. First of all, there's a map at the end of the orientation packet, so definitely check that out. Two, starting next week, there will be student guides on campus that can help direct you to your classes or other offices on campus. They will be here, so next week, it'll be between 10 and 4, and then the week that classes start, it'll be 8 to 6, Monday through Thursday. So Monday is a holiday. So I don't know if there's actually gonna be any guides or if the campus is even gonna be open on Monday. Let's say Tuesday through Thursday, it'll be open 8 to 6. And then on Friday, not open, they'll be there. And then they'll also be there 8 to 4 on Friday. So just know that there will be people to help you find your way. I will also just give you the heads up that GCC is not set up in an intuitive way. And a question you hear a lot is, can I help you find something? Because we're all very used to kind of keeping our eye out for folks who have kind of lost looks on their faces. And I will tell you, as someone who has been here 5 years, I still get turned around and will be like, nope, this staircase did not take me where I thought it was going to take me. So, oh, and there's signs that say this way to these, room numbers, this way to these room numbers. So get used to looking for those. Know you can ask anyone. One of the things that's great about GCC is folks really are quite friendly. All right, let's talk Moodle. So you found your way to Moodle because you found your way here. And that's one of the things that's really great actually about the way we do orientation when it's virtual is that we know that you have at least engaged with engaged with Moodle ahead of time. So when you log into Moodle, it looks something mostly like this. On the left-hand side, so this is your dashboard. On the left-hand side, there will always be a link to your dashboard. It won't always be at the top, but you can find that you can always get here by clicking the dashboard link. In the center, these are your classes. These are set up in the card view, but you can have them organized in like a summary list or a list, or maybe it's called details, something like that. But so you can set that up however you like. You can also find your classes over here on the right-hand side. Yours will not be quite so crazy looking because you will have been here a shorter period of time. I want to draw your attention to the section that says GCC community, which is where you found orientation today. When you go into a class, it's going to look something like this. All right, here's something that's really important to know. Each of your instructors is going to set up their Moodle site differently than your other instructors. Everyone has their own way that they like to organize things. So one of the things you want to do is for your classes that have their Moodle sites available ahead of time, and not all classes do, but they will be available the first day of classes. You want to go to that Moodle site and check it out, and just to kind of familiarize yourself with how that instructor has laid things out. At the top, you usually will find like some like basic stuff, like a quick way to get the class announcements, a copy of the syllabus. If there's a Zoom link for either the class or office hours or something like that, you'll find that there, and other general course information. Below that are the topics, and different instructors will do different things with the topics. So pre-pandemic, in the before times, my class is actually set up thematically. So all the readings were in one place, all the class handouts were in another place, all the homework was in a different place. And that worked really well for me. And then things went sideways. And I was like, yeah, I think now that everything's remote, I'm going to do stuff on a weekly basis, because that will make things, I think that will make it clearer for everyone. So you really want to make sure you know how your instructor has set up their Moodle page. If you're feeling a little nervous about this, I'm going to say a really great thing that you can do, and it's something I actually require my students to do, is set up an appointment with a peer tutor. And you can do that now. Peer tutors are working now. They work through the summer. They work during the semester. Just to like go over each of your Moodle sites and make sure you understand what's there. And also while you're meeting with the tutor, I would go over any syllabi that you have, just to make sure you understand how that instructor has set up their syllabus, because that's another thing that instructors do differently from each other. They set up the syllabus in a way that works best for them. So just know that you don't need to kind of like suss this all out on your own. You absolutely can, you know, reach out to folks to get some help with that. And peer tutors are an awesome resource for that. All right, one of the things I wanted to draw your attention to is these two resource menus that are always available on Moodle, whether you're on a class screen, if you're on the dashboard. One is the GCC links, and the other is the student support links. If you click on the GCC links, these are the things that are there. And the two things I really want to draw your attention to at the moment is this remote and online learning for students option, and this Moodle users for 21-22 option. If you go to the remote and online learning for students, and this, I am giving you all homework, and that homework is go to the remote and online learning for students page through the GCC links and do the watch this Moodle tour. It's all of like maybe 8 minutes. You have 8 minutes. And then there's some practice that you can do. And what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to show you what I am talking about. So wait, I got to move these Zoom controls out of my way. All right, so here we are in Moodle and on the GCC links. I'm going to click on this remote and online learning for students. If you scroll down, so it might look like this for you. Everything might be compacted. Just push on, click the arrow, and then you get the same information. But I really want to draw your attention to, you obviously can look at all of these other things, but I want to talk about using Moodle. There's this helpful little tour, as I mentioned, and this is what it covers, all of these things, which you're going to want to know. But the other thing it does is it gives you an opportunity to practice posting, practice submitting an assignment, and to practice taking a quiz. And those are all things that you're going to want to know. What are other things I wanted to show you? I wanted to talk to you about the, again, under GCC links. So that's what you should do before classes start. You can look at the Moodle users for 21-22 before classes, or maybe you want to like get a little bit more of the lay of the land and then look at it, that's fine. But what I just showed you in the remote and online learning for students is a good intro. So you'll see that this gets updated every year. So this is updated for this year. And there's a couple things in here I want to draw your attention to. First of all, know that there's more than just information about Moodle here. We're going to start at Moodle for students. What if your class isn't showing? There's some information about that. This is only if your instructor happens to be using Lightbox Gallery. I have no idea how many instructors do, but also you can get information on assignments, quizzes, and grades for students. Some of this is similar to what we just saw on the previous page, but this gives you information like, oh, I have a Chromebook. How do I submit assignments from a Chromebook? How do I do it from G Suite? How do I check the status of my assignment? And how do I see grades? So lots of helpful information is just right here that you can find really easily. There are other things I wanted to show you here. Moodle for all, everyone, how you can change your preferred name in Moodle. Information about other things you can do, dashboard, lots of information. So that's all right there. So you can check that out too. If you have a Chromebook, how it works with Moodle. And then there are other tutorials here that I wanted to make sure you saw. So tutorials on using Zoom, creating a PDF, creating videos, and if any of your instructors are using these platforms, how to use those platforms. So I just wanted to let you know that all of that is there. So that's the two main things I wanted to make sure you noticed on the GCC links menu, but I also want to talk to you about the student support links. This seems pretty obvious, brings you to the student handbook, brings you to the Math Studio webpage. We're going to talk about that later. We're going to talk about peer tutoring later. This gets you to the student help desk, how to get your email on your smartphone so that you can check it every day, and then links to other departments or services that are helpful to have at your fingertips. And also, this will bring you to My GCC if you want. So that's all I wanted to show you in Moodle for now. So we're going to get back to our presentation. I have to find where we left off. Just need to find the purple. This is about where we left off. So let's go there. So talked about the Moodle Users Classroom, Moodle for students, and then the student support services, support links, talked about those.